In 2012, BAE Systems and General Atomics started developing one of the United States Navy's most ambitious and unique projects, the Electromagnetic Railgun Cannon. This weapon system features electromagnetic launchers that use electricity instead of gunpowder and other chemical propellants to fire projectiles at incredibly high speeds, even reaching Mach 6 at a range of more than 220 miles, leading to shorter engagement times, longer ranges, and extended keepout. The expectations were incredibly high, and if successful, the gun would eliminate the need for high explosive warheads and reduce engagement costs. And it was also considered to arm the Navy's powerful Zumwalt-class destroyers for a new generation of combat. United States Naval Artillery. For decades, U.S. Navy battleships could fire shells for distances that could exceed more than 30 miles. During World War II, the power and effectiveness of naval guns were never questioned, and their use was prevalent during iconic battles such as the preliminary bombing campaigns on the islands of Peleliu, Iwo Jima, and Okinawa. The U.S. Navy bombardments in defense of the South Korean shores during the Korean War were also effective in putting the invading communists at bay. Still, such powerful weaponry was gradually replaced by missiles, which had better range and could cause more damage while also providing a safer distance for engagement. Naval artillery was then relegated to land attack cruise missiles and anti-ship missiles, among other types of state-of-the-art weapon systems. However, despite being the most fearsome asset for waging war at sea, missiles are far from perfect. They can still be countered by sophisticated anti-missile systems, some of which include high-powered lasers, jamming devices that get in the way of the targeting system, or electronic warfare suites that can hack the missile and render it useless. Meanwhile, even the latest and most advanced missile defense systems, such as the American Aegis missile defense system, can be overwhelmed by multiple missile volleys. Amidst these developments, traditional cannons were left behind, incapable of finding a new spot to fit in. Still, traditional artillery seems to have resurrected during the last decade, after recent technological innovations have opened the possibility of producing a powerful alternative to modern missiles. And surprisingly, its origins can be traced back to the middle of World War II, right in the heart of Adolf Hitler's Third Reich. A German innovation. As World War II steadily turned to the Allied forces' favor, the Third Reich was unable to take the initiative anymore, and Germany was slowly overwhelmed by the military, industrial, and economic superiority of the Allied forces. Still, the Führer put his faith in the wonder weapons, hoping they would change the fate of the war. In early 1944, Officer Joachim Hensler from the Wehrmacht's Ordnance Office proposed the first viable anti-aircraft railgun to defend the Fatherland from the Allied bombing raids on German cities. Months later, when the Allied forces had launched Operation Overlord and Dragoon to reclaim France, Hensler perfected his theory behind the electric anti-aircraft railgun, allowing the decaying Luftwaffe to issue a requirement. The German Flak Command requested a weapon that could launch an explosive projectile with a muzzle velocity of 4,500 miles per hour. These railway guns were to be fitted, in batteries of six, into existing 12.8cm Flak 40 mounts and achieve a rate of fire of 12 rounds per minute. The idea caught some attention, but it never saw the light of day. Still, when the war ended and the victors took over the country, Joachim Hensler's design was studied in detail and led to a U.S. Army report from 1947 that stated that it was feasible but would require almost half the power to illuminate an American city. Electromagnetic Railgun Cannon. The idea to create a weapon similar to Hensler's World War II design began in 2005 with a joint effort between the U.S. Navy, BAE Systems, and General Atomics. The objective was to develop a long-range electromagnetic railgun cannon that would use high-power electromagnetic energy instead of explosive chemical propellants to launch a projectile farther and faster than any gun before. According to BAE Systems, quote, "When fully weaponized, the railgun will deliver hypervelocity projectiles on target at ranges far exceeding the Navy's current capability." The EM railgun, as the company has called it, can be compared to a large electrical circuit that uses magnetism to accelerate a projectile at tremendous speeds that can exceed those of a missile and a gunpowder charge. And it comprises a power source, a moving armature, and a pair of parallel rails. In the article titled Navy Evaluating Second Electromagnetic Railgun Prototype, the Navy stated that, quote, magnetic fields created by high electrical currents accelerate sliding metal conductor or armature between two rails to launch projectiles at 4,500 to 5,600 miles per hour. As such, an electric pulse is sent to the railgun, creating an electromagnetic force that can accelerate a projectile to Mach 7.5. Phase 1 of the project began in 2012, when engineers at the Naval Surface Warfare Center in Dahlgren, Virginia, fired the EM railgun prototype at tactical energy levels. The objective was a proof-of-concept demonstration at 32 megajoule muzzle energy. Following the successful tests, the Navy awarded BAE Systems a $34.5 million contract for Phase 2 in July of 2013, as part of the Navy's Innovative Naval Prototype Program. The railgun's development was carried out by BAE Systems in Minneapolis, Minnesota. The railgun's first shot. The United States Navy's Electromagnetic Railgun Cannon fired its first shot on November 17, 2016, at the Naval Surface Warfare Center, Dahlgren's new terminal range, located in Dahlgren, Virginia. The location is used by the U.S. Navy to test and experiment with the latest technical innovations that can be implemented in its fleet to bolster its capabilities. Footage taken by personnel from the Office of Naval Research and Naval Surface Warfare Center shows how specialists first inspect the electromagnetic railgun cannon to ensure every piece of hardware is properly installed before firing. Then, personnel from the control tower begin a virtual preliminary assessment to ensure electricity and power are at their maximum. Once everything is in order, the American railgun fires. The launch package, consisting of a sabot, a projectile, and an armature, was fired at Mach 7. A 25-pound projectile then impacted several targets at Mach 5 with high kinetic energy and went straight through them with relative ease. Ultimately, the projectile can easily penetrate the armor plates of armored vehicles and other metallic objects that protect a target from explosives and rocket-propelled grenades. Shelving the Navy's railgun. Despite the railgun's initial success, it has many shortcomings, and the main one is that the weapon system tears itself apart with use. Every time it is fired, the massive power at which the projectile is launched shreds the barrel, diminishing its effectiveness with usage. In addition, the cannon requires an enormous amount of power to function correctly, which many analysts believe is not feasible for use aboard U.S. battleships. In July of 2021, the U.S. Navy announced it was canceling research and development of the electromagnetic railgun after spending approximately $500 million over 15 years. Chief of Naval Operations Admiral John Richardson told Congress that, quote, the barrel itself is probably the limiting case. The engineering on that, the materials required to sustain that power pulse, and the heat and power that's involved in launching those projectiles. The Navy's intent was to equip its Zumwalt-class destroyers with this brand new weapon system. It remains to be seen if the project will be restarted or if they will need to look for a hypersonic missile alternative. Thank you for watching our video. Please like and subscribe to our Dark Documentaries channels to find more exciting historical content. And don't forget to hit the bell icon to be notified of our newest videos. Stay tuned for more.